Hello students, today I am going to explain the chapter From Storytelling to Filmmaking from your ELR book. The title of the chapter itself suggests the subject of this chapter. Yes, this chapter tells us about the origin and development of filmmaking. Everyone likes to watch movies, isn't it? But in primitive time, even books were not there. In their leisure time, people used to sit together and used to explain what they had seen or experienced. As time went on, a person who is capable of explaining experiences in an interesting way was chosen as the storyteller for the masses. Then gradually the storyteller started performing or enacting also. This storytelling and enacting paved the way for drama. They were named as actors. Actors soon became a special band of people. They were called to different places for entertaining the people. Business-minded people started making stages, and stage was used for performance in lieu of money. Thus, the theater came into being. One such theater was Globe Theater. Shakespeare used to write plays for this Globe Theater. Over time, the scene of action shifted from the theater stage to the film screen. Means, gradually, film came into being and theater became backdated. Moving images and sound replaced real people on the stage. So, theater became backdated and moving images, because of this moving invention of movie, this sound system, etc., all this. Motion pictures became possible with the development of technology. In the late 19th century, specific inventions and new knowledge of light and sound paved the way for motion picture industry. So, invention of light and sound, that was the beginning of this movie or cinema industry. Before recording the moving images, action was shown by changing the position of figures or objects from one picture to the next. So, how they used to show action? Still pictures were captured, and one after another, through the one after another still picture placing, they used to narrate the things, and that was only motion picture for that time. Then came bioscope, and the first real step towards motion picture were the result of scientific experiments in the persistent of vision, and that was bioscope. But bioscope could be viewed only by a person, only a single person. So it was having its limitation. And next step towards motion pictures combined the revolving disc principle with the magic lantern, or project a series of drawing on a wall or screen so that they could be viewed by a number of people all at once. Means what it is? Pictures one after another were placed, and with the help of light of a lantern or etc., it was projected on the wall one after another. So it became the concept of motion picture, and many people can together watch this motion pictures on wall. That was only the motion picture of that time. Then by 1870, inventors in the United States and England had developed devices which mounted still photographs of motion on a revolving disc. So what they did next step, that was still pictures they just put in a reel, and then the reel was projected in front of, it's just placed in front of light, and the light that then the pictures were reflected or projected on wall, and that was the motion picture. The earliest forms of film making began in 1877 over a bet on whether a horse lifted all four of its legs up into the air while it was running. So, how it came, the concept or the first motion picture? It was a bet between maybe the friends or maybe the people. They were betting over a topic that while running, a horse lifted its all four legs or not. For this, to find it out, a photographer named Edward Muybridge set up a row of 12 and later on 24 cameras to take pictures fast enough to capture the jump of a horse. So one after another, all the cameras are set while the horse was running, and just together all the pictures clicked and that joined and then gave the total picture of the horse movement, and it was the first continuous motion photography. And soon after this, American inventor George Eastman used a transparent flexible film, which is called celluloid, with the camera he had invented. And this invention of celluloid was the greatest boon in making motion pictures. Okay, now the first people credited, means the first credit of using celluloid film, goes to American inventor Thomas Edison and his assistant William K. L. Dixon. By 1890, they had developed the kinetograph. What is kinetograph? A motion picture camera. They developed a motion picture camera called kinetograph. And a motion picture camera that used Eastman film and developed the kinetoscope. Okay, so the development of next step is kinetoscope. But soon kinetoscope parlors had opened in the United States and Europe, and people started enjoying motion pictures there. Now, next stage or step in development of motion picture is the invention of cinematography. Yeah, just see here. What is this cinematography? It's a combination of camera, printer and projector. All of you know what is a projector because you all enjoyed smart classes. That is a projector only. So here this cinematography, it is a combination of camera. Camera is to capture the photo. Printer is printing the picture, and then projector is showing it. So these three things together came into a complete compact thing, and that is cinematography. It is the boon. It is also the latest, latest development in taking motion picture. But this is also became something more is required. The audience, their demand developed day after day. But early films were complete different from today's what we enjoy today. Early films were complete different from this films. Why and how? Because early films were silent movies and those were completely black and white. Music was only from background. And few examples of early films, this type of, I know that all of you enjoyed Charlie Chaplin, Laurel Hardy, and just recall what you have seen there. Black and white pictures and only music from background, no dialogue. So it's completely different from modern movies. So I said audiences demand always increase, and they demand it. They wanted to enjoy dialogue also along with motion pictures. Thus, this demand was fulfilled with the development of technology, and speech or dialogue became inbuilt part of movies or motion pictures. Thus, these films with speech or dialogue came to be known as talkies. Okay, but that time also the picture was black and white. So again, taste people always demand more and more. And with the advancement of technology, now color also added to the pictures, and the development of this color, then a three color process was introduced in 1932. The Technicolor, which is known as Technicolor. In 1950 came the Eastman Kodak Company, and the movies now had vastly improved color tunes. And you all enjoy these days science fictions, etc. You know how much the development taken place in film making. And America, the film industry is known as Hollywood, and in India it is known as Bollywood. Okay. So this is the information that we receive from our chapter, from storytelling to film making. So initial stage it was only storytelling, then gradually today's film developed. Okay, I hope you have understood this chapter, and in case of any doubt, kindly text me or you can just inform me. It's a lengthy chapter. You need to understand the stages, how the film making developed and it reached its pinnacle, the successful situation or the position that is called pinnacle. That is we are enjoying today, what we are watching movies today, we are enjoying in that. It's the successful stage. How it reached its today's stage, that is total steps you have to understand. I hope you can read it on your own, and once again I am repeating, in case of doubt kindly inform me. Thank you, students.